Today we celebrate Palm Sunday, a very sacred time in the church year where Jesus enters into Jerusalem during the last week of his life. We are glad that you could join us, and may this service be to the glory of God, and it may offer you the peace, the hope, and the opportunity to praise. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
After he had said this, he went ahead going to Jerusalem, and when he had come near Bethphage and Bethany at a place called Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples saying, "Go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' just say, 'The Lord needs it.'" So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owner asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" They said, "The Lord needs it." And then they brought it back to Jesus. And after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it, and he rode along. People kept spreading their cloaks on the road, and as he approached the path down from the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds and the power that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise in heaven and glory to God in heaven." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, order your disciples to stop." And he answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout." Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Our psalm today is a psalm of preparation for Jesus' entry into Jerusalem, Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord's, and all that is in it, the world, and those who live in it.
For he has founded it on the seas, established it on the rivers.
Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord?
And who shall stand in his holy place?
Those who have clean hands and pure hearts,
who do not lift up their souls to what is false, and do not swear deceitfully.
They will receive blessings from the Lord,
and vindication from the God of their salvation.
Such is the company of those who seek him,
who seek the face of the God of Jacob.
Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors,
that the King of glory may come in.
Who is the King of glory?
The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle.
Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up,
O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in.
Who is the King of glory?
The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves. And he said to them, "It is written, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers." The blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he cured them. But when the chief priests and the scribes saw the amazing things that he did and heard the children crying out in the temple, "Hosanna to the Son of David," they became angry. And they said to him, "Do you hear what these are saying?" Jesus said to them,
"Yes. Have you never read, 'Out of the mouths of infants and nursing babies, you have prepared praise for yourself?'"
He left them and went out of the city to Bethany and spent the night there. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace to you and peace from God our Creator and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So today we celebrate Palm Sunday. This is something that lifelong Christians have celebrated since childhood. Those of you that are new to the faith, this is the celebration of Jesus coming to Jerusalem during the week that he is going to die. It's the triumphant entry into Jerusalem. It's people recognizing him as Messiah, even though they don't know what to do with him. We're in a hard time now. We're in a time of pandemic. We're in a time when we are socially isolated. Any other Palm Sunday, this sanctuary would be filled with the young and the old and children and adults raising their palms and singing "All glory, laud, and honor," or praising Christ. Now we do it in our homes. Now we do it in our hearts. If you want palms, they are on the front steps of our church. Just go on Sunday or any day this week and pick up a palm, take it home. Remember that God is present. Usually, I speak theologically about how this is preparation for the death of Jesus. This is a time when all of the Pharisees and the Sadducees and the rulers who do not want their authority questioned decide that he has to die because of the triumphant entry into Jerusalem, or because of the children singing "Hosanna to the Son of David" in the temple. Today I want to stay with the entry into Jerusalem, a time when the people recognized who Jesus was. They didn't know what to do with him, but they knew that he was special. They had been waiting because they were there for Passover, ready to prepare for Passover, and they were wondering if Jesus was going to come to Jerusalem. And when they saw him far afield, they gathered. on the road that went from Bethany down the hill past the Mount of Olives into the Golden Gate, which is the gate to the temple. They laid their cloaks on the ground. They took palms from the trees. They proclaimed at the top of their voices, "Hosanna to God." How do we celebrate in a pandemic? How do we celebrate the coming of Jesus into Jerusalem? For me, this story is more relevant than it's probably ever been, because we as God's people celebrate Jesus at the same time we look forward to his death and eventually his resurrection. If we are not one of the families that has been affected by the pandemic, we are still in a place where we can celebrate, where we can lift up our palms and we say, "Glory to God in the highest heaven." But that there are those in our community that are already affected. There are people who have passed in Minneapolis and in St. Paul and in the state of Minnesota. And they're part of our story. We celebrate even as death surrounds us, even as death is on the horizon, because we're a people of faith. And we know that no matter what, we have the full story, and God is going to be there for us, for each of us. My father, I think it's 3 years ago, passed. He had been in a nursing home, and all of a sudden he began to deteriorate, and he was put on hospice. And instead of the family grieving that he was on hospice, we decided that we were going to throw him a hospice party. And within one day, our family came together from Wisconsin and Iowa and Minnesota, and we had a huge celebration celebrating his life. And we're not a perfect family. And there's a lot of discord and a lot of anger in our family, but we come together when we need to. We come together to celebrate those whom we love, those who might be on the verge of death, those who are afraid. That's what this story is about. Jesus set this up. He told the disciples to get the colt. He told the disciples this was going to be pageantry. He went on the most populated road into Jerusalem so that the entire temple and all of the leaders would see him. He walked boldly, or rode boldly, on the colt into darkness. And that darkness is around us. And we turn on the TV and we see numbers increasing, whether it be deaths or those infected with COVID-19. We can look to him on how to be people of faith, how to boldly go forward in our faith, how to celebrate the people around us, how to reach out and tell them that they are precious in God's sight, and that no one is alone. And even though the world seems like it's being turned upside down, it'll be okay. I need this story. I need to celebrate. I need to gather with my family who's just gotten a Zoom account so that we can all get together and try and make my mother laugh in assisted living and see my brother's face or my sister roll her eyes. We need each other. And we need our God. And in the midst of potential darkness, there is life. Bless your neighbor. Bless your family. Bless frontline staff. Bless the person on the other side of the grocery aisle or who checks you out. Celebrate. To God be the glory. Amen. We continue with prayer. As we enter this holy week, together let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Let us pray for the church throughout the world, that our sisters and brothers in every land may be renewed in the mystery of Christ's entry into Jerusalem, his last supper, his betrayal, his crucifixion, death, and resurrection. May we have the courage to follow wherever our lives lead us, and as God's people to fully participate in Holy Week. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let us pray for the fragile gift of creation, especially as we see your new creation emerge around us. Let us be good stewards of all that you give us. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let us pray for those in need, for those who are lonely, who work at relationship, who long to be heard, who search for your presence and direction. We pray for those that know illness or grief, who know fear or anxiety. We now lift them up either aloud or silently in our hearts. We pray for healers on the front lines, whether hospital, clinic, care center, or public servant. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let us pray for the nations of the world, especially in this time of pandemic, fear, and hopelessness. Remind us that you are here to be our strength and to meet our needs. We are never alone. No matter the circumstances of our lives, hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands, O God of love, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We continue with the ministries of Vista Lutheran as we continue to be God's people in the world. I would like to thank all of those who are part of our calling tree, who are reaching out to our members to see what their needs are, what their prayer concerns are. Our prayer chain has never been as busy as it is right now. A thank you to all of those who are leaders in this place, to our musicians who gather at a safe distance to share their gift of music and love and light. For Sarah and for Luke and for John, who is running the camera today, thank you for sharing with this congregation. We are, as Vista Lutheran, going to be the East Side Drop for STEP. And on Tuesdays until 5 p.m. and on Saturdays until 3 p.m., we will be collecting food and monetary donations at Vista. We will be taking the food in and giving it time to decontaminate 3 or 4 days so that STEP can take it, put it immediately on their shelves, and distribute it to those in need. And we thank God for this opportunity. We also, because of the sale of former Prince of Peace, were blessed, and we were able to share with STEP after consultation with finance, visioning, and executive and council, our heart. And we were able to send them $10,000 to help them meet their goal of $180,000 this past week. You, as God's people, I know, are taking care of the people around you, even in your own fear, even in your own distress. Know that we are here for you. And if there's anything that we can do to support you or to support your loved ones, please reach out to us. We are God's community of faith, and we celebrate one another and our neighbors and St. Louis Park and beyond, because we have members who live in Hopkins and other places, and we thank God for this opportunity to be that people of faith. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Greet your family members with God's peace. Look into their eyes and say, God bless you. We continue with We Are Enough. Bring back some wine or milk or juice or even just water, a cracker and some bread, and prepare to take Holy Communion with us. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people. For the forgiveness of sin, do this in remembrance of me. We pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Take your bread. The body of Christ, given for you. Blood of Christ, shed for you. The body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Now as we go out to God's world, as we celebrate each other and God's creation, as we minister to those in need, as we face our own fears, Know that we do not go alone. Hear the Lord's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you all that you need in mind, body, spirit, relationship. May our God meet your fears and your anxieties and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thanks be to God.